Hi and welcome back. This video discusses course flow and weekly schedule, assessment, and how to create your syllabus. Remember this slide from our Teaching and Learning Styles video? It's back to show the importance of aligning your course goals and learning outcomes with your course content, the activities you assign, and assessment. Here's a quick table of how course assignments and activities actually align with different goals. For example, grading students on their ability to watch video clips or lectures does not actually demonstrate a learning goal that requires them to apply or create. Creating a matrix like this may help you choose which assignments and activities to include in your class. So how to share all this course information with students? We suggest being completely transparent with your syllabus. Consider adding a section at the beginning of your syllabus that actually details a course overview. This could be the same course description on the registrar's schedule of courses. Share your expectations and provide a basic outline that's easy for students to understand. The overview you see here should be familiar. It's this class. You should see that we have no hidden agenda and we want to make sure that everyone in this class knows exactly how this class will function. Other options we've seen are a group of FAQs or even a visual map of the course flow. Now on to the weekly course schedule. Again, clarity is of utmost importance, which is why we created this table that you're welcome to use. Make sure everything is available, including due dates of activities and when you'll be returning feedback. Believe me, this will cut down on a lot of student questions and really helps to lower student anxiety. Feel free to color code and make things easier to understand by using visual tricks to organize your content. Moving on to assessing those activities, I hate to sound like a broken record, but please consider aligning what you are grading to the actual course goals. One way to do this is by using rubrics. You can even use the learning outcomes you created as criteria to assess a student's work. And we have many examples of rubrics that you're welcome to use. In fact, the URL at the bottom of the slide contains hundreds of thousands of rubrics teachers all over the world use and that you're welcome to take and modify to fit your own course. There are rubrics for discussion board posts, discussion board responses, final essays, and much, much more. Since many hybrid and online classes are condensed, make sure you're able to give feedback before students are asked to submit another activity for grading. That's the basis of the feedback loop. You can also provide other types of feedback, such as written narratives or even video responses. You can even record yourself reading through their work and send them the video.